So yesterday we so far completed about skeletal system. Today is muscular system. Okay. Coming to the functions of the muscular system. So wherever we need a movement, there and all we have muscles. Without muscles, the movement is not possible. Always the movement is possible with contraction. We call it a shortening. And by lengthening, which we call it as elongation. With shortening and lengthening, the movement is possible. And shortening is very beneficial than lengthening. Lengthening, it will be like stretching part. So muscle is a type of elastic tissue which can stretch. And coming to the organs of muscular system, muscles. So this is the whole muscular system. We have different types of muscles. You can see here, this muscle is called masseter. Masseter means chewing muscle. This muscle is called sternocleidomastoid. And this muscle is deltoid. Just know the few muscles, very important muscles. Only the important muscles are shown in this picture. So this is deltoid, this muscle. And this is triceps. So triceps and biceps are very familiar with bodybuilding people. And biceps and triceps. And this muscle, we call it as pectoralis major. And this is rectus abdominis. So rectus abdominis is actually the packs. So 6 packs, 8 packs are because of this muscle only. Rectus abdominis. And next, this muscle name is external oblique. And here we have adductor femoris. So this muscle is adductor femoris. And this muscle is sartorius. Sartorius is the lengthiest muscle in the whole body. And next, this muscle is quadriceps femoris. And this is vastus medialis. And this is gastrocnemius. So gastrocnemius is present on the backside of the leg. And this is tibialis anterior, which is present on the front of the leg. So these are the major muscles of our body. So the major skeletal muscles. So coming to the combining forms, fascio. Fascio means the fibrous band which is enveloping the entire muscle, we call it as fascia. And fibro. Fibro means fibers. So muscle fibers. Kinesio means movement. So kinesiology, study of movement. Musculo means muscle. Myo. Myo is also muscle. And myocardio. Myo means muscle. Cardio means heart. So heart muscle. Myoso. Myoso means also muscle. Actually, myosin is the protein present in the muscle. Planto. Planto means sole of the foot. Tendon is tendon. Tendon is the part which makes the muscle to attach with the bone. I'll show you in the picture. These are tendons. So this is tendon. So this white color part is the tendon. This actually comes along with the muscle. It makes the attachment between the muscle and the bone. So this thing we call it as tendon. Tendon is different from muscle. So different from ligament. Ligament will make an attachment between bone to bone. Muscle will make an attachment. Tendon will make an attachment between muscle and bone. And next, tendo is tendon. Tendino is also tendon. All the three forms means tendon only. Tino, tendo, tendino. And next, asthenia means weakness. So myasthenia means muscle weakness. Kinesia means movement. Tonia is tone. For example, myotonia means muscle tone. Ab means away from. So abduction means away from the body. Adduction means towards the body. Ad means towards. Sarcum. Sarcum means round. So these are the movements. Abduction means taking the hand away from the body. Adduction means bringing the hand towards the body. Circumduction, which means making a circle. Coming to the anatomy and physiology part. So bundles of muscle fibers. So muscles are arranged in the form of fibers. So the muscle cell will be in the form of long fiber. So the fibers will usually shortens the length and produces the movement. And the bones will move closer because of the shortening. So the muscles are present in the digestive system, blood vessels, in the internal organs also, we have the muscles. So coming to the types of muscles, we have 3 different types of muscles based on the placement and based on their function. The skeletal muscle. So the skeletal muscles will attach to the bone. So the skeletal muscles are actually striated and voluntary. Striated means you can see the lines on that. And unstriated or non-striated means there is no lines on it. So there are actually two types of muscles. One is voluntary based on the action. One is voluntary and other one is involuntary. Voluntary means which will be under our control. Involuntary means which will be on our body control. So voluntary muscles are skeletal muscles. Involuntary muscles are smooth muscles and cardiac muscles. So in this picture, you can able to see, you can see the lines actually. So these we call it as striations. So this is skeletal muscle. Skeletal muscle is actually striated voluntary. And next, cardiac muscle. Cardiac muscle is striated involuntary. And next, stomach. So stomach muscles are the smooth muscles. Smooth muscle is unstriated or non-striated involuntary. So because of non-striated nature only, they named it as smooth muscle. So you can't see much lines here. So this is cardiac muscle. Cardiac muscle is present only in the heart. So skeletal muscles will attach us to the bones, and which is voluntary, and it has the striations. You can see under microscope. And skeletal muscles are a whole, the muscle is wrapped by a cover. We call that cover as fascia. And end of the muscle, we have the tendon. Tendon will make the attachment between muscle and the bone. And the skeletal muscles are being stimulated by motor neurons. Motor neurons of the neurons which are coming from the brain towards the muscle for response. We also call these neurons as efferent nerves. And the attachment will, we call it as NMJ, neuromuscular junction. So it was given in reverse, myoneural junction or neuromuscular junction. So in this picture, they have been given a differentiation, visceral muscle or smooth muscle. No striations. And it was involuntary. Here, skeletal muscle, striations, voluntary. Cardiac muscle, striations, but involuntary. So that's it. And some of the names are rectus abdominis. This was actually present in the abdominal region for creating the abs. Sternocleidomastoid. This is present in the neck region. So there are two origins, sternum and clavicle. Gluteus maximus, the largest buttocks muscle. So the largest muscle in our body is gluteus maximus. Flexor carpi, which actually bends the wrist. External oblique. So these muscles are oblique muscles present in the abdominal region. Biceps. Biceps means having two heads. So coming to the other part. So skeletal muscles will make an attachment between two different bones and overlaps the joint. So it makes contraction and extension. So origin will be less mobile for two bones and insertion. Origin means point of attachment. Insertion means ending point. Starting point we call it as origin. Ending point we call it as insertion. You just remind like that. And coming to the actions. So the skeletal muscles will produce, for example, if it is flexor carpi, means it will use the bending of the wrist. So that was the action. Antagonistic means the opposite action, we call it as antagonistic. Agonistic means whatever the action it performs. Antagonistic means the opposite action. For flexion, the opposite action we call it as extension. So this was the flexion, is we call it as, if the muscle is for flexion, then we call that muscle as agonist. So the opposite action, we call it as antagonist. So coming to the terminology part, abduction, moving the body or limb away from the midline. Adduction, moving the body towards the midline or moving the hand or leg towards the midline of the body. Flexion means bending of the wrist or bending of the elbow, bending of the shoulder. Extension means making it again back to the straight condition. We call it as extension. Dorsiflexion, I'll show you in the picture. So in this picture, you can able to see when this hand is towards the body, we call that as adduction. When the hand is moving away from the body like this, abduction, we call that as abduction. When you make a circle with the hand, then we call it as circumduction. When you bend your elbow, we call it as flexion. When you straighten your elbow, we call it as extension. So this part, this we call it as dorsiflexion. Standing on the heel, we call it as dorsiflexion. And raising the toes. Opposite, we call it as plantar flexion. So rising the heels and standing on the toes. So this is dorsiflexion and this is plantar flexion. So eversion. Eversion means turning the foot in outward. Inversion means turning inwards. Pronation. Facing the palm towards the floor, we call it as pronation. If you are facing the palm towards the ceiling, we call it as supination. Elevation means to rise. Depression means to drop. Circumduction means making a circle. Apposition means, if, for example, if you want to count your numbers with your fingers, you'll put the thumb towards the fingers. That we call it as apposition. Rotation means rotating around the joint. We call it as rotation. So coming to the word building part, fascial means fascia. Fasciitis, inflammation of the fascia. Fasciotomy, incision or cut to the fascia. And kinesiology, study of movement. Muscular, pertaining to the muscles. Polymyositis, inflammation of many muscles. Myalgia, which means muscle pain. Myasthenia, muscle weakness. Electromyogram, study, so recording the electrical activity of muscle. Myocardia, pertaining to the heart muscle. Myopathy, muscle disease. Myoplasty, surgical repair of the muscle. Myorrhaphy, suturing of a muscle. And myorexis, muscle rupture. And tenodynia means tendon pain. Tenoplasty, surgical repair of the tendon. Tenorrhaphy, suturing a tendon. Tendoplasty, surgical repair of tendon. Tendotomy, incision into the tendon. Tendinitis, tendon inflammation. Tendinous means pertaining to the tendon. Bradykinesia, which means slow movement. Dyskinesia, which is difficult movement. Hyperkinesia, excessive movement. Hypokinesia, which means insufficient movement or decreased movement. Atonia, which means lack of tone. Dystonia, abnormal tone. Hypertonia, excessive tone. Hypotonia means decreased or insufficient tone. Myotonia, muscle tone. So coming to the vocabulary part, adhesions. Adhesion means if we have any injury to the muscle, so there will be scar development in the fascia. That makes the movement difficult because of the scar formation. That we call it as adhesions. Atrophy. Atrophy means decreasing the muscle bulk. So opposite we call it as hypertrophy. If you see the bodybuilding people, their muscle will be larger than us. So that condition we call it as hypertrophy. For example, if we are on dieting or if we having any disease, fever, we lose our weight. We lose our muscle bulk also. That we call it as atrophy. So contracture. Contracture means abnormal shortening of the muscle fibers, such as tendons and fascia. There is without lack of movement also, the shortening of the muscle fibers will take place. Hypertrophy, increasing the bulk of the muscle. So, and next, intermittent claudication. We itself will also have this experience. So suddenly during night time, if you stretch your foot, so you will have muscle cramps on your backside of the leg. That we call it as intermittent claudication, the severe pain with the insufficient blood supply, which is caused by muscle ischemia. Muscle ischemia means lack of blood supply, usually seen in the calf muscles. Calf muscles means the muscles present on the backside of the leg. Spasm, sudden involuntary strong muscle contraction, we call it as spasm, which is not done voluntarily. So it will happen involuntarily. Torticollis, we also call it as wry neck. So if you see, some people will got fixed with the neck will be locked in one position, sideward position. That we call it as torticollis. That is because of neck spasm, neck muscle spasm, means involuntary muscle contraction of the neck muscles. Fibromyalgia, so muscle pain, with severe muscle pain, we call it as fibromyalgia. lateral epicondylitis. So the elbow muscles, nearby the elbow, the inflammation will be takes place in the elbow muscles, so which is caused by strong gripping. So we also call it as tennis elbow or lateral epicondylitis. Muscular dystrophy. So inherited disease with progressive muscle atrophy, we call it as muscular dystrophy. So it was came from our parents and forefathers. So this leads to decrease in the muscle bulk. Pseudo hypertrophic muscular dystrophy. In this case, actually the person muscle bulk will be larger because the muscle cells will die. So that was replaced by fat and fiber. Because of the replacement of fat and fiber, that muscle bulk will be looking bigger. But that is not actually true muscle. That was replaced by fat. Carpal tunnel syndrome. This is usually seen for the typing people. So nearby the wrist, there will be compression of the tendons and the nerves. So this causes the severe pain in the hand and the thumb and finger muscles. This we call it as carpal tunnel syndrome. And next, ganglion cyst. So the cyst will be seen. Cyst means which is water-filled bubbles, we call it as cyst. So that water-filled bubbles are seen in the tendon region, usually seen in the ankle and wrist and ankle. And next, repetitive movement disorder. If the person is subjected to repetitive pressure, vibration and movements, so they will have a chronic disorder seen in the tendon, muscles, joints and nerves. And next, rotator cuff injury. So the whole shoulder muscles, all together we call it as rotator cuff. If there is any injury to that particular muscles, we call it as rotator cuff injury. Strain, any damage to the muscle and tendon, we call it as strain. It may be because of overuse and overstretching. Usually strain is seen for the athletic patients. Coming to the laboratory test, CPK, creatine phosphokinase. If any disease to the muscle or any damage to the muscle, so the CPK levels will get elevated in the blood. So if they go for the blood test, if the CPK levels got elevated, then the doctor will confine. So the person is having some muscle abnormality. Next, deep tendon reflexes. If we usually see near neurologist and orthopedician, they'll be carrying one part, an instrument called knee hammer. If they tap on the tendon, so the limb, the hand or leg will flicker. So that we call and will respond to the tapping. That we call it as deep tendon reflexes. Electromyography. So to see the strength and quality of the muscle, we will check the electrical activity of the muscles. Muscle biopsy. Removing a piece of muscle tissue for examination purpose. Usually this will be seen to see the Duchenne's muscular dystrophy and pseudo hypertrophy muscular dystrophy in those cases. Carpal tunnel release. So to relieve the pressure on the wrist, usually they'll cut the ligament on the wrist to relieve the pressure, which is caused by carpal tunnel syndrome. And tenodesis, just surgical stabilization of the joint. So they'll use the tendons to anchor the joint. If there is any immobility or hypermobility with the joint, they'll use the tendons to anchor between the joint. And coming to the pharmacology, skeletal muscle relaxants. So usually given to promote sleep or to relieve the spasms. Coming to the abbreviations, CPK, carpal tunnel syndrome, and CPK, creatine phosphokinase, and DTR, deep tendon reflexes. EMG, electromyography, recording the electricity of the muscle. IM, intramuscular, usually the injections are given as intramuscular. MD, which means muscular dystrophy. And next, yeah, that's it. Okay, any doubts regarding this? No, ma'am. Veena, you got completed with the entire topics, right?
Yeah, yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. Ramya?
No, ma'am.
Sheikh Ali. Hello. Shittik Ali. Am I audible to you? Joy?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you got the topic? Do you understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I'll share you the PPT today. And by default, you don't have class on Sunday. Class default. Okay. Veena, from tomorrow onwards, you can go to the coding class. You just talk to your HR. They'll be guiding you to the coding class.
Okay.
Just if they call you regarding the classes, just tell them all the classes you got attended with me.
Okay.
Joy, how many topics left for you?
Ma'am, completed 6 topics, ma'am.
Completed 6 topics?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. ENT topic got completed for you, nose?
Ear rise completed, ma'am.
Ear got
completed. Yes, ma'am.
Ear topic got completed, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Reproductive?
No, ma'am. Reproductive, skin, endocrine, respiratory.
Only those 3 topics are there.
4 topics, ma'am.
4 topics.
Reproductive, endocrine.
Respiratory.
Skin. Respiratory, skin, ma'am.
Okay, then on Monday I'll go with reproductive system.
Okay.
Ramya, is it fine for you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, you can leave for the day. Tomorrow you don't have the class because on Sunday, by default, there is no class. On Monday, we'll see you on Monday.
Okay.